again. This is Nick. I just watched your video on how to add text boxes into charts in Excel. Two ways, both by adding them and then grouping them together, or putting them inside the plot area and kind of trapping them inside the chart. I love how you referred to it as trapping them inside the chart. So anyone out there, if you're interested in learning how to put text boxes inside of your charts, go ahead and watch the video linked above and below to my friend Anne. But what I wanted to go ahead and do is share something that has been really frustrating for me when doing this sort of technique. So this is an Excel right here, and these are just my text boxes inside of the chart. I have them kind of trapped inside, just like you say. But what I love to do, of course, with text boxes is use the alignment tools to make sure that they're perfectly spaced or perfectly aligned to the top, to the bottom, to the left, whatever. And so I'm going to hold down the shift key, select both of my text boxes right here. I want them to align to the top. So I'm going to go to the shape format menu, go to the alignment tools here and say align to the top, and now they align perfectly to the top. That's wonderful. That works in Excel. For some reason, it doesn't work that way in PowerPoint. So this is the exact same chart. My text boxes are trapped inside of the plot area. You can see right here, these are just text boxes. Now, if I hold down shift and shift to select both of those text boxes and try to align them to the top, I can go up to the shape format menu, alignment, and then go to the top, align top, and nothing happens. Is this just me, or is this everyone? It seems like something that PowerPoint should probably be able to fix. So I'm left in PowerPoint. If I do this in PowerPoint, I'm left to either use the grouping method and make sure the text boxes are outside of the chart first, align them perfectly, and then group them together, or I'm just gonna kind of sit here and eyeball it just a little bit, and I think that looks okay. One kind of interesting tip that I've picked up before is that if, this works in Excel too, if you hold down the, if you select a text box or any object and you hold down the shift key, then you can drag it just in a horizontal plane or in a vertical plane. Whereas if you don't hold the shift key, you can kind of just drag it around in a circle and it can go willy-nilly all over the place. But if you just wanted something to move over a little bit to the left, but you were worried about maybe making it, getting some misalignment there, all you have to do is hold down that shift key and then drag it across the page, and it kind of keeps it in that horizontal plane or a vertical plane for you too. So that was kind of a nice little tip that I like. But still, the alignment tools don't work on these trapped text boxes in PowerPoint. So Microsoft, hear me, please. Let's fix this in PowerPoint so it can work just like Excel. So thanks again, Anne, for the inspiration on this video. I just had to jump on and say hey, and everyone who's watching this, I hope you go and subscribe to Anne K. Emery. Wonderful DataViz on the go tips for you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it so you can get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint. So hope you all have a great day, and I can't wait to see you next time.